At least it's not there. Yun. I wanna see everybody also kasi. Hi everyone. Okay lang ba? I'm so excited. I'm so excited talaga. Because honestly, hindi ko po alam kung matutukan yung minsan yung mga news. Minsan na news ako. First of all, of course, again, I want to introduce myself. Ako po si Valenciano. And it is a privilege to be here for all of you tonight. And I'm gonna be sharing some things na baka magulat kayo. Kasi yung ibang tao baka hindi aklain na mangyari sa akin yun. And I want to be, after this, my only goal after this is ma-bless kayo and ma-inspire kayo. I want nothing in return. I don't expect anything. I just want you to be blessed. Nagano ba lang to? Okay. Dito na lang. Okay. Where do we begin? From the start. From the very start. Well, I'm honored to say that I was born into an amazing family. My mom and my dad, talagang nagtrabaho sila. Kasi ang dami nang sasabi sa akin before na, alam mo, masasabi ko ng buhay mo, no? Kasi Valenciano ka, no? Masasabi siguro kasi galing yung daddy mo, yan. Proud ako. Kasi ang sinasabi ng mga tao sa akin palagi, and this is the truth. Maganda lang, nakapunta ka lang naman ng States kasi daddy mo ganyan eh. Hindi, maganda kasi paaralan mo kasi mayaman kayo eh. I'm proud to say na nagsumikap ang aking mga magulang to be able to give us, mga kapatid ko, a life like that. That's why doon ako na-inspire. That's why I work hard. Para masabi din ng mga anak ko one day na naghirap din ako, which is true, and I'll explain later kung paano nangyari yun. And so that's the start. I was born a Valenciano. I didn't choose this life. God ordained this life for me from the very start, before the earth was created. We are all meant to be who we are. The question is, who are you? Right? Hindi pala kayo tatanong eh. Because God knows who you are. But do you know who you are and do you know who He is? And that was the question. I was born into a Christian family. Christian family kami. Wala akong choice. Pupunta kami ng Sunday school, pupunta kami ng church, di ba? Ano nangyari? Naging ano siya, routine. So, this is where I start my story. So ako, ang character ko kasi very ano ako eh, outgoing. Ano na po yung outgoing? Yung mga tao, very social, gusto kong makipagkaibigan. Alam niyo, for example, nag-stay ako dito tonight, lahat kayo kakausapin ko, as much as possible. Ganun akong tao. And ang nangyari, growing up, hindi alam ng tao to, growing up, binuli ako sa school. I was bullied from kindergarten all the way to high school because of who I was. Valenciano. Diyan sa pakipak ako, tinutulang ako kayo pagkain ko, ginaganyan. And yung mami ko, being the strong Christian woman that she is, would always tell me, son, what does it say in the word? Turn left, turn the other side, right? The other cheek. Ano bang other cheek? To love your enemies as you love yourself. To never do anything in retaliation, instead with grace. And medyo nag-backfire. Alin pa yung backfire? Ano ba meaning nun? Backfire meaning, may gusto kang gawin, magandang intention mo, pero mali pa rin ang nangyayari. Iba pa rin ang nangyayari. So, growing up from grade school to high school, medyo, alam mong tawag nun ko, yung bitter, parang nasa loob lahat, yung kulo, lahat nasa loob. Tinig ko lang kasi binubuli nga ako. Before anything pala, yung best friend ko nandito, si Patrick Gariado, where you bro? Hi, best friend ko yan. Ever since 2006, nag-meet kami niyan sa Bible school sa Manila. And he saved my life many times. As in, seryosong saved talaga. And so, grade school, okay ako. High school, medyo tumatalagit na. And then, college. Alam niyo, guys, when you're born into a family that is struggling with poverty, na mahirap, talagang sumisikap kayo, pero parang wala kayong hindi ko talaga masasabi na naintindihan ko. But when you're born into a family, at nung bata ka pa lang, sinasabi na you'll never be like him. And who am I talking about? Maybe. I dance like him. We're the same. Mas patanggat ako ng konting-konti lang, pareha-pareha yung style namin. But I don't sing as well as him. Hindi naman po dita. And I had, growing up, bata pa lang ako, ilan 4 years old. Ay, kamukha mo daddy mo, pero di ka naman kumakanta eh. Since 4 years old, 8 years old. Alam mo yung parang dadaan ka, uy, alam ni Gary mo. Ay, parang ang pangit niya, parang hindi siya kumukha ni Gary. Tapos 12 years old. Ayun na, tapos nag-asa pa ko. Sino ba dito? Teka lang. Sino ba dito 20 below? 20 years old below, sino? 30 below. O sino pa 100 below? So sino dito nakaabot na sa asap ko? Sino man nanonood, nung buhay may marriage na sa asap ako. Okay. Ako kasi afraid, I love to dance. I love to perform. Gusto kong, mahilig akong gumawa ng kanta.
Pag huli niya.
Nung pumasok ako ng asap, doon na nag-start. And this is where I really, really begin. The downfall and how can I say yung pagbaba ng bat ng buhay ko. I got married young. And it didn't turn out the way I wanted it to turn out. And I'm sure napabasa niyo yun about my failed marriage. And I'm very open about that kasi I'm not going to defend myself nor am I going to attack my ex-wife. But ang isa lang masasabi ko, everything happens for a reason. And that reason has to be heaven sent. Because ang mangyayari is when you start making decisions on your own, you're relying on your own knowledge, your own carnal ways. Carnal ways is worldly ways. Eh. When you start looking to God, and I'm telling you, I'm not perfect. Sobrang work in progress pa po ako. Sobrang dami ko pang kailangan puntahan, malaman, matuto, patuhan. When you start looking to God, your decisions start becoming God-like. And ang nangyari sa akin, I grew up as a Christian, so naging routine na siya. So nakalimutan ko na kung paano yun. I forgot how to look to God and say, Lord, what do I do? Lord, nasaktan ako, anong gagawin ko? Lord, ganito, what did I do? I turned to the world. And lahat ng nanggaling ko sa mundo, lahat ng galing ko sa mga tao, the bullying, even social media, cyberbullying, ang dami talaga. Imagine, I would get 50 to 100 messages a day. Mura lahat, everything was a curse. You should be ashamed to be a Valenciano. Dapat di ka na pinanganak. Ganyan. This is the reality. Joseph will agree with me. Ang buhay na artista or ang buhay na celebrity ka, it's not easy. Especially being the son of someone like my dad. Like, for example, Tito Martin, Mama Martin Rivera, kilala ko din yung mga anak niya. Hindi madali. Karel, o Tito Shasha, hindi madali. Because once you're born, meron ng expectation na magiging ganun ka. I know I'm not gonna have hits like Sana Mauli-Muli or Shout for Joy or Hataw Na. Kailangan kita. How did you know? I'm never gonna have hits like that. Pag nagka-concert ako sa Aneta, mapupuno ko ba yun? Pag nagka-concert ako sa Mawa Alina, mapupuno ko ba yun? That's the worldly way of thinking. But I'm here now. With you.
Center.
Diba? And this for me is fulfilling and contentment and a blessing. I don't need an Araneta when I have Nueva Vizcaya.
Yes! Diba?
And that's what my dad would always tell me. Sabi niya, son, love you, bro. Sabi ng daddy ko, son, if you've impacted one life, nanalo ka na. Because when he was a non-believer, yung daddy ko kasi hindi naman siya, he was born a Christian. Ang isang tao na nag-share sa kanya is my mom's parang bayaw. Ang ganun. And he took a risk to share to my dad. Hindi pa siya talagang galing. And he impacted one life. And my dad has impacted millions. So my dad always tells me, son, it just takes one person. You don't need to impact millions at a time. Pwede naman isa, dalawa, tatlo. Correct?
Yes.
And that's why when I I'm gonna talk about my marriage and everything else later. Thank you, bro. I'm gonna talk about everything else later, but I'm just showing you how my parents raised me. And that's why yung mga sometimes, diba, there are some people here that yung purpose niyo hindi niyo alam. Parang feeling niyo irrelevant kayo, worthless. Trust me, I feel that every day. Because even if sometimes malakas ako, feeling ng tao na palagi ako nagpapatawa, na ako palagi yung life at the party, I'm struggling on a daily basis. That's why I want you guys to know that you're not alone. And so, moving forward, I lost my way. I left to the States. I'm not sure if you guys know this, but I only saw the States. Doon ako nagtinangang for 4 years. And nung nasa States ako, lahat sa akin. Lahat. Nag-school ako. I graduated very well in my class. I had a good job sa LA, Los Angeles, California. Ang ganda. I had a wife. I had a nice house. Pero araw-araw, umuwi ako kasi manila ako. You know why? Kasi para sa akin, my success was based on me. May kotse ako maganda. May mga motor ako na maganda. May bahay ako na maganda. But, what about the souls? What about the people? Nakalimutan pa na yung mga tao. I forgot why God put me here. Which is to influence Ang problema kasi ngayon, social media, which is so easy, I'm sure lahat tayo dito may social media, kahit paano, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Pwede. Ang problema kasi is that we are being fed the wrong things. Or correct, right? We're being fed the wrong things. And here's the thing, ito yung problema. Kahit ang buong araw mo, kunwari nanalo ka ng loto sa umaga, sige, yay! Tapos na-promote ka, yay! Masaya tayo, di ba? But it just means, it just takes one bad news. Isa lang, para yung buong araw mo sila. Bakit ganun? Diba? Ako ganun din ako eh. Sasabihin sa akin, God, may project tayo na maganda. God, lilipat tayo na, oh yay, sobrang sama ng buong araw. And then may isang tweet lang, isang tweet. May mag-tweet lang, pangit mo, God, ba't ka ba ganyan, ganyan. Buong araw ko sila na. Ma-insecure na ako. Mas matatamaan ako. And that's the problem right now. So here we go. I'm gonna share with you what happened within the last 5 years of my life, which defined my life. After my marriage, after the failed marriage and all that, and the divorce, I fell into a very dark time in my life. I was 27 years old. Like I said, si Patrick, but why he saved my life so many times, kasi nandun siya. Almost every day, natutulog siya sa bahay, sa hospital. I tried to commit suicide twice. And it wasn't because nagpapakansin ako. It wasn't because I was trying to prove something. I was trying to escape reality. At this point, God was not buried in my life. Wala na God. Parang binumuna ko na siya eh. Kasi sanabi ko, grabe ka, buong buhay ko, binigilo sa kapas. Ganito, iiwan mo na ako. So for the past three years, this year lang ako this is the only year that I got back on my feet. But for the past 3 years, I have been struggling with depression. I was diagnosed with bipolar 2 and clinical depression. I'm under meds every day just to stay normal. Sometimes I cry. Pag minsan umiiyak ako. Kasi ang dami kong gamot eh. And sometimes I pray to the Lord and I say, Lord, this mga gamot na to is the only way for me to stay normal. Ganun ba talaga buhay ko? Is this it for me? I tried to commit suicide by overdosing with illegal substances because I was abusing the substances 2 years ago. And at that moment, sasabihin ng mga tao sa akin, God, ba't di mo tinawag? But nandun naman kami. I live so near you. Malapit na naman tayo natin. Di mo tinawagan. Patrick, bro. Di mo tinawagan. At that moment, kasi I'm not sure if there's anybody here that has thought about this. Trying to end your life. Ayaw mo natin. It's kanil. But if there's someone here that knows someone or ikaw man yun, you know what I'm saying. You feel so alone. Na feeling mo ikaw lang. You're battling this alone. Na ikaw lang yung... And I tried. I overdosed on 4 different substances. And pag-gising ko, I was in the hospital for 10 days. Ayaw nilang palabasin. And my thought process was, Lord, actually, ito talaga ito. Lord, ba't di mo na open? Bakit? Dapat pinano mo na. I don't care kung heaven or hell. I don't care. At that point, wala akong pakialam. Doon yung time na diagnose ko. Kasi no normal person would do that. And then I realized, everything na pinento ko sa inyo, ever since bata ako, all the way up to college, all the way up to nagtatrabaho na ako, sumabot na talaga siya in one day. Failed marriage. Everything. Ang dami na sasabi sa akin, nakakaiya ka. Valenciano ka pa naman. Ganyan ka. Nakakaiya ka sa magulang mo. Nakakaiya ka. Ang dami kong kaibigan na tumalikod sa akin. I lost a lot of friends. And in the hospital, one of my pastors, visited me. And you know what he told me? He asked me one question. Pastor Paul Chase. He asked me, he goes, God, why are you alive? Why did God spare you? Or why did God kill you alive? Alam naman na nabibuko, bakit? Because sa lahat ng tingin ko nung gabing yun, it was enough to kill 2 horses. 2 kabayo dapat ang mamatay na. But when I had my CT scan, when I had my everything, yung general check-up, MRI, lahat, I was perfectly normal. Oh. And I believe that's God. And so, tinanong ako, why are you alive? Why do you think you're alive? At that time, hindi ko pa po alam kung bakit. Oh, binuhay ni God. Sa dami-dami kong failures, sa dami-dami kong ginawang masama, until today, sometimes I still stumble, and I'm still trying to find my way. And then it clicked. It clicked. And I told him, maybe it's because God put me here not just to entertain, not just to perform, not just to be Gary Vee's son, but maybe he put me here for people. Maybe he put me here so that I could understand why the world is suffering. And that is my commitment right now. That's why I'm here. Because I want you all to know that you're not alone. And you never will be alone. And that realization, when you tell yourself, it's a beautiful thing. And even when you stumble, di ba, as a Christian, alam natin kung ano yung tama at mali. Pero ginagawa pa natin yung mali, di ba? But now, like David, now that when you make a mistake, instead of telling yourself, ito na naman tayo, I'm not good enough, I'm worthless, which I do all the time, I'm worthless, mali na naman ako. Remember, we serve a God that put us here not to be perfect. He put us here to serve and love Him so that He could love us too. So always remember that when you fall into that trap, when you fall into sin, the Lord doesn't look at you and say, grabe naman to. The Lord is just saying, okay, Maria, alam mo, come back. It's okay. Think of it this way na lang. Yung mga kanina dito, magulang mo, mommy, daddy, para si daddy. Pag ikaw ba ay, let's say, nagkamali ka sa buhay, mag-aaway kayo ng magulang mo, correct? Di ba? Kanina may ginawa, kalbito ako eh. Or lasing ka, pag uwi mo, ganda kayo sa magulang mo, nag-aaway kayo, correct? But does it mean that they don't love you? Does it mean na hindi mo din mahal yung magulang mo? No. How many times na ako, with my mom, ako, hanggang ngayon nag-aaway pa rin kami ng mami ko. Minsan sinasabi ko sa girlfriend ko, you know what? Babe, ayaw na kausapin sa mama. Hindi kami mag-uusap for 2 days. Pero pag nakita kami, hug ko, I love you mom, sorry, ganyan. It's exactly the same with God. The only difference between your worldly parents and your heavenly father is that He is perfect, beyond perfect. He's the creator and the savior. Your parents gave you a worldly life. He's giving you eternal life. So if you're able to look at that, look at God in that way, and tell yourself, I am never gonna be alone. And then you have a good, you surround yourself with good people. You surround yourself with family, with friends that care about you. And then you have a God that loves you unconditionally, a God that wants to give you everything that you deserve at the right time. Saan ka pa? Why did I say I tried to commit suicide, boys? Because when I was diagnosed the first time in the hospital, binigyan ako ng mga gamot, di ba? I started to find my way, I get, mababalik na konti ako, fine, okay, yan, gab, ito na yung tama, okay. And then I stopped taking my meds. Tinigil ko, kasi inisip ko, okay na ako eh, di ko na kailangan ng gamot ko. So binitawan ko yung gamot ko. January, was it January? Mga 27, this year. Mga January 26, 27 of this year, something happened in my life. And, nag-trigger siya eh. Because when you have mental illness, you have trigger points. Okay, it could be a loss of a family member, it could be drug abuse, it could be alcohol, it could be women, di ba? Ako, trigger point ko is pag ina-attake yung self-image ko, pag ina-attake mo yung pagkatao ko, na minamaliit mo ako, because nga, growing up, lahat ng tao ginawa sa akin yun eh. So something happened, January 26. And this is the time, I think, na mas it was more critical than the first time. Because this time, I was on the 22nd floor of a condominium hanging by the balcony with 2 fingers. January 27. And the only thing that really stopped me from doing that was my family. I was hanging like this, tumitigil ako ganyan, may swimming pool, may kung ano-ano, sabi ko, sa isip ko, bukita ko kaya ako dito. Mabubuhay kaya ako. And let me tell you, I was 2 seconds away from letting go until naisip ko yung pamilya ko. Naisip ko yung minamahal kong girlfriend. Inisip ko yung mga kaibigan ko. Unlike the first time, kasi yung first time, wala akong inisip eh. But that wasn't even the clincher. Hindi nga yun yung pinaka kung bakit ako hindi bumitaw eh. Just God. You know why? Because right below me, sa baba ng, sa 21st floor, right before ako, talagang pili ba gagano na ako? bumukas yung ilaw sa 21st floor at nagulat ako. And I went back up. Hindi ko kilala kung sino yun nasa baba. This was 4:30 a.m. in the morning. Hindi naman ako sumisigaw. Hindi naman ako, di ba? Why did that life open? Again, it's God. I have some scars here because there's broken glass. Tapos kinuha ko yung glass, ganun ko. If you go on my Instagram, makikita nyo, last week nag-post ako sa World Suicide Prevention Day. And makikita mo talaga, ganun ko siya. Because with bipolar 2, extreme siya eh. Okay, it's either you're very happy or you're very sad or depressed. And at that point, I was also under the influence of alcohol. And I couldn't believe, di ko makapaniwala na again, ganito, ako na naman, parang mali na naman ako, da-da-da-da-da-da. Talagang kumalun talaga ako doon, and I was gonna let go. The next day, I went to the hospital on my own accord. Pero syempre, yung pamilya ko, sinabi, alam na naman ang pamilya ko. But, hindi sleep over doon sa hospital. Natulog sa hospital, I think 2 nights. And that's when I really realized, sabi ko, God, listen. Strike 3 na to, kung paano na to. God spared you 2 times. And I genuinely believe that he'll spare me the 3rd time and the 4th time. Why? Because now I know why I'm here. And why is it again? People. You know, alam niyo po yung meaning ng empathy? Alam niyo po yung meaning? Empathy? Empathy is being able... Okay, the difference between sympathy and empathy. Sympathy is, I sympathize with you, I feel bad for you, I'm so sorry na namatay yung mami mo, or I'm so sorry that, you know, I sympathize with you. Empathy is understanding that feeling on a personal level. Because you've been there. Alam niyo ba guys na within the past week from the post that I posted on Instagram, people have been messaging me, "Hi Gab, I just read your post. My father just committed suicide 2 days ago and I don't know what to do. Hi Gab, because of your post, 2 days after, dapat mapapakamatay ako. Thank you for your post. Gab, my sister committed suicide 10 years ago and I'm still not over it." Empathy is telling that person, "I know, I understand, I've been there." We have a pastor, right? Last week lang. A pastor committed suicide, correct? Suicide. Like, what, last week? He had a beautiful family. A beautiful church. I'm guessing he had a beautiful life. But the enemy came to kill, to steal, kill, and destroy, correct? And he knows your greatest and deepest weaknesses. And this is why my mom always tells me, always, "Gab, don't undermine the devil." Because he knows, he's smart. But who's made it his image? The devil or us? Us. Who do we have on our side? The devil or God? God. And so, I'm telling you this not because I want you to feel sorry for me. Hindi ko sinasabi ito para sabihin mo, "Oy, God, kawawa ka naman." Hindi ako kawawa. I'm blessed. Yes. I am incredibly blessed. Amen. That's why right now, pag nag-share ako ng mga story, nakikita niyo ako. Alam niyo, ano yung may ginagawa ko before yung mga video na sumasayaw-sayaw ako? Yung malaki yung buhok ko. Nakita niyo ba yun? Not yet. Sana nga nag-no kayo eh. Kasi yung suit ko nun, shorts ko nun, ganun katas. Diyan yung mga video. Noong time na yun, I was depressed. Ginagawa ko yung mga, I was doing the videos, yung mga pang, Robin Williams. Di ba? Robin Williams committed suicide, he's a comedian. Don't undermine the devil, because he knows your weaknesses. But God is God. We have to understand. Sino ba dito goes to Christian school? Meron ba dito? Meron din. Catholic school, Christian school. Okay, you know when, minsan parang may mga memory verse of the week and you have to like memorize it? May ganun, di ba? I was 4 or 5 years old, and we had this parang test. And basically, ang mangyayari is, magbibigay sila ng mga Bible verse. Tapos kailangan mong ma-memorize the next day or 2 days later. Eh, sa akin, book chapter. Psalm 100. Okay, God, for you, Psalm 100. Verse what? Psalm 100. Okay. And I had to recite it the next day. I had to recite Psalm 100 the next day. So what happened? Umuwi ako. Antipolo pa kami. I mean, I lived in Antipolo pa that time. Sabi naman po saan, you know, logo ko, read. Okay, shout for joy. Shout for joy to the Lord. Worship the Lord of Gladys. Shout for joy. Hindi ko talaga kaya. Until one day, I was only 4 or 5 years old. Imagine having to memorize an entire chapter. And then one day, I mean, that night, my mom said, "Son, why don't you pray to God and ask Him to help you?" "Mom, pray na naman na, but we have to pray about everything. We have to pray when we eat, we have to pray when we sleep, we have to pray about magpupunta ng word, Lord, please protect." But now I have to pray for Him to give, to memorize this word, di ba? May ano nangyari? Once I closed my eyes, and I'm not joking, on my life, I promise this, I close my eyes, and I go, "Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth, worship the Lord with gladness, come before Him with joyful songs, know that the Lord is God. It is He who made us yours, we are His people, the sheep of His pastures. Enter His gates with thanksgiving and His throne with praise. Give thanks to Him and praise His name, for the Lord is good and His love endures forever." Alam mo yung feeling na, and His love endures forever. Thank you. Love you. So, that was my prayer. And I have never forgotten it since. And I think that was my first major spiritual encounter at 5 or 4 or 5 years old. And that's when I started to believe, oh my God, there's a God. Siyempre, kasi magpata ka pa, parang, God is spirit. For you, God is like this big thing. You never really understand it. You never really understand Him. But that was the first time. And that's why. And the line, the last verse there is what really stands out. His love continues through all generations. And what does that mean? What does all generations mean? How many generations have gone before us? What is the one? There's actually, no, sorry. Two. What are the two constant things in life? There's only two. I mean, life and death is given, diba? But there's only two things while we're living. There's only two things that are constant. Money is not constant. Changes. Currencies change. Styles change, people change, technology changes. What are the two things that don't change? Time and God. So the only two things that don't change in life, and the two things that you can't buy.
Time.
So understand that when you put yourself in God's presence, it's not a Sunday thing. It's not every Sunday that you're praising God and then you go on to the week. No. Do you know what a Sunday Christian is? A Sunday Christian is a Christian that goes to church every Sunday and calls himself a Christian. Ganun ba tayo?
No.
Before I go, I want to be able to put this into your mind, into your heart, because I stand here not as a suicide survivor, not as someone that has been beaten, has been destroyed, that has been broken, because we all are broken somewhere, one way or another. Diba? So don't be ashamed of it. Don't be ashamed na, "Oh, I have a deficiency. Ay, medyo mababa yung grades ko ngayon. Ay, I have a sickness. Ay," you know, don't look at it that way, because you're like that for a reason. And that, whatever it is that you feel is that cannot be healed, that cannot be fixed, that cannot be put together, you're with the master maker up there. You're with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the one person that can put you whole. That's why, look at me right now. I'm healthy. I'm happy. I'm fulfilled. I know where I want to go. I know what I want to do. Yes, minsan, I still stumble. Minsan, may nasasabi ako na dapat hindi ko sinabi. Sometimes, may naniisip ako na hindi ko dapat isipin. But at the end of the day, I know where I'm going. Amen. And I know who I'm going with. Alam niyo, just ano na nga, side, ano na nga, si Joseph, dati ko pang kilala yan. Tito vibes na kami niya na kasi same generation kami niya. I just wanted you guys to let, sinabi ko pa kay Pato eh. I said si Joseph has always been one of the nicest guys in the industry na kilala ko. So can you just give him a round of applause? Kasi it's not every day na makakilala ka ng tao na ever since na kilala mo sa industry, na babae, na ano. Hindi sa mayabang din, pero okay lang naman kasi guwapo eh, what can we do? So with that said, guys, I'm gonna give you at least 2 to 3 things to remember. And it's a cycle that we all go through as Christians and as human beings. Because para sa akin, if you're Muslim, if you're Buddhist, I am in no place to judge you. Ever. Only one person can.
It's good.
Am I correct?
Yes.
That's why as Christian, I peace. Please, please, please. Ang nangyayari ngayon, a lot of my friends na hindi Kristiyano, sinasabi sa akin, "Bro, napaka-judgmental nyo eh. Lahat na lang na ginagawa namin, mali, di ba? Di ba, kami lang naman ipupunta sa impyerno, di ba?" Never judge people. Always be kind.
Amen.
Because in the Bible, Jesus spent a lot of time with non-believers. He spent a lot of time with sinners. And let me tell you this. be very, very, very vigilant, because the one person that betrayed him was a believer. Remember that before you judge others. Because people are now looking for something. Ang problema kasi ngayon, naghahanap sila, diba? They need something. Napakatalino, napakayaman, pero hindi sila masaya. Bakit? They're looking for something. We have to represent Christ the right way, and the way that He would want us to represent Him. Because at the end of the day, guys, this is it. The young ones here, you are our future. Amen. Yes, sasabihin nyo, oh, grabe naman. Future. Eh, ano naman ako eh. Estudyante lang naman ako eh. No. Remember that when you become a Christian, you put Christ inside you. He becomes your hope. And everywhere you go, you represent Him and what He stands for. All these thousands of years are now inside of you. The wisdom, the knowledge, the love, the compassion, the gentleness, everything. So when someone comes up to you and says something that you don't agree with, what do? You love them. Amen. You forgive them. Because that is what God would do. That is what Jesus would do. I'm not going to sit down here and tell you that my life is great. It's amazing. It's perfect. Grabe, Valenciano, I've been through so much, ang lakas-lakas ko. No. Sometimes, magigising ako, and because I do have an illness, sometimes, magigising ako, and I tell myself, ako na dito. Lord, what else do you want me to do? Hindi ko ba sapat yung ginagawa ko? But I go back to the Word. I go back to surrounding myself with good people. I go back and I tell myself, you're here for you. And I'm here for you, you're here for me. So, here's the cycle I'm talking about. There's losing, there's finding, and there's keeping. What does that mean? You can lose your way, you can find your way, and you can keep yourself there. How does that mean? That ina nangyari sa akin, 2016, 2017, 2018. Sorry, 2017, 2018, 2019. 2017, I lost my way. Sobra. 2018, nahanap ko, okay, God, this is you, what do we do with this? And 2019, I'm here to stay. So that's how you should do your life. Pag may problema ka, okay lang mawala eh. It's okay naman na, it's okay to be, it's okay not to be okay. Pwede naman na hindi ka okay. Don't ever think na, ito na naman tayo, mali na naman. No, it's okay if you make mistakes. Because the Lord will forgive you, but what is your heart telling you? Where does your heart want to go? As a young person, as a young student, someone that's just getting into work, someone that's just starting out, young couples, nothing. Actually, sorry, not nothing. Everything that you do, Christ must be the center. But always. Always. Because if you don't do that, if you start acting on your own, this is what's going to happen. Yan ang nangyari sa akin. I thought na kaya ko lahat. I thought na kaya ko gawin lahat by myself, on my own. What happened? And I don't want that to happen to you. I want you all to wake up in the morning, yourself, today is going to be a great day.
Amen.
Today is going to be a good day. Today is the day the Lord has made.
We will rejoice.
And when you go at night, when you're about to go to bed, you tell yourself, Lord, you know what? Today could have been better. Sana hindi nangyari to. Sana hindi. It could have been, you know. But you know what? It's okay, Lord. You know why? Because magigising ako tomorrow and you can try again. Because the sun will always rise the next day. So, the ending of my story is here I am now, with everything na pinagdaram ko, lahat ng mga trials, all the challenges that I've been through. But instead of looking at it as something na, grabe pinagdaram ko naman, Lord, grabe naman, look at it as a blessing. Because whatever, like I said, what the devil uses for the bad, the Lord will use for the good. Not just the good, the great. My dad has had diabetes for what, 35 years? But how many diabetics, how many people with diabetes, how many thousands and millions of people with diabetes has he inspired through his illness? Alright? So be like Jesus. That's it. You don't need to be perfect. Just be like Jesus. And He will lead the way. Alright? So with that said, guys, thank you so much for this time, for me to be able to share with you my story.
It's
20
plus
now. But it's okay, we'll be in Man Up Here pa. So we'll do this stuff for Reba. So thank you so much, Life Talk, for having me, Pastor you know, it's been an amazing time so far. I've only been here for one day, pero sobrang blessing because again, everybody has been so warm, napakabait ng mga tao, and I feel like I'm at home. I will definitely come back. Life Talk, please, can you invite me again? And I will be back here, and I will give you guys a show, for sure. So, with that said, God bless you. Thank you so much. I'm Gad Valenciano. Of course, Joseph has been here as well, and thank you so much.
Once again, let's give it a hand to God Valenciano.